Chebokssari is located in the upland Volga region and stands on the shore of the Chebokssari Reservoir. It was first mentioned in written sources in 1469. In 1555 a fortress was built here. The Chuvash name Chubashkar literally means the fortress of Chuvash. With the construction of the hydroelectric power station, the level of the Volga rose considerably and a number of historical buildings are underwater now. Fortunately, we can still see some old churches and mansions. The mansion of Fyodor Ефремов is among them. It is considered to be one of the most beautiful mansions built in Chebokssari at the beginning of the 20th century. The building attracts everyone's attention as it looks amazingly harmonious. Besides, there is a romantic story connected with its construction. Its original owner, Fyodor Ефремов, was the youngest son of the richest merchant in Chebokssari. Fyodor did not want to marry any of the local beauties. He brought his bride from a business trip to the south. Her origin was unknown, but she could dance and sing well. The high society of Chebokssari scornfully called her actress. Still, Fyodor was so much in love that he disobeyed his father and married her. He wanted to please his wife with a beautiful residence. The family provided Fyodor with the money to build a house away from their mansions. The architect chose the modern style. The interiors were decorated with luxurious stained glass, marble fireplaces, and an iron staircase. Soon, the place became famous with the local elite who attended their receptions and enjoyed music, dance and arts. Nowadays it houses the art gallery. Visitors can enjoy impressive portraits, picturesque landscapes, exquisite still lifes and thought-provoking genre paintings by Russian and foreign artists.
In the gallery, one can see portraits depicting people of different ages, characters and background. They look at the visitors and it seems that they are eager to share their life stories with us. We recognize familiar faces of Natalia Narishkina or Emperor Paul I. We studied the portraits of people whose names are unknown, but their images are vivid and powerful. It sometimes seems that they study us, their descendants too. Visitors to the gallery can feel the mysterious link between the past and the present. Dandelions by Levitan is among the most famous paintings in the gallery. There is a mysterious story connected with the picture. They say that once Levitan visited his friend's country house and found a beautiful meadow with dandelions. The artist picked a small bouquet. Immediately after arriving home, Levitan put the dandelions in a clay vase. Surprisingly, the flowers were still fresh. The artist hadn't painted anything for a long time, but he decided to paint those flowers at once. Unfortunately, he still had no inspiration and nothing worked. Levitan was in despair. At that moment, he noted that one flower wilted. It was sad but moving. The artist decided to try again without taking the flower away. He started working. In a couple of hours, the picture was ready. The artist was inspired. As time went on, Levitan tore off small pieces of petals and added them to his paints. That year he painted a lot of pictures. Some say that dandelions help the artist. Who knows, but many artists say that they feel inspired when looking at the picture. Different people are inspired by different things. However, visiting an art gallery seems to be a universal source of inspiration.